And we are back here on Metalholic Radio. You just heard I Am the Gun off of the new Vicious Rumors album coming out May 7th, Electric Punishment. And right now we have the main man, the founder, the guitar player, Jeff Thorpe of Vicious Rumors. How are you doing, brother?
I'm doing great, man. Thanks so much for the call.
Oh, absolutely. I've been wanting to touch base with you for a while. It's like old home week. It brings back memories of, I don't know if you even remember the magazine. Do you remember The Informant and back in the day?
Of course. Sure, man.
Yeah, I was the editor of that for, God, years. And I remember I was, wow. Yeah, and Andy was the publisher or whatever you want to call him. I was the editor. And, God, I remember when you guys signed, after the first two albums, you guys signed your, what is it, seven-album deal with Atlantic?
Yeah, something like, well, a seven-album deal that we ended up doing three out of. But hey, that was a great run and an exciting time for sure.
It was. I mean, for those who are unfamiliar with it, you guys came out of the Bay Area, and they've always sort of equated you with sort of American power metal, although I think that was sort of short-sighted in terms of the way people talk about Vicious Rumors. But you guys came out at the same time in the Bay Area that the thrash scene was really starting to rev up and everything. And you guys just had more of a straight traditional metal sound. It was just edgier than what people were used to.
Yeah, we definitely kind of have, the bands in the Bay Area, some of the long time. I'm proud to be from the Bay Area and part of the history of these long term bands from around here. I mean, when you think about it, Vicious Rumors, Testament, Death Angel, Exodus, Forbidden. I mean, granted, Vicious Rumors never took any time off the whole time, so we might also stand alone in that category. But all those bands are just, have stood the test of time so far. So it's exciting to be part of that. And yeah, we, out of all those bands, we're probably a little more on the outside, where they all have a little kind of more of a thrash click together. But we were just always influenced by like big arena bands and shows and really musical stuff. I think if we're known for anything, it's for the way that we have a sort of our own special way of mixing like brutality and melody together. And it's been a lot of fun, and I feel very fortunate to have had such a long 35 years almost of heavy metal madness. It's just been incredible.
Absolutely. I mean, and that's sort of what I was saying. It's like you guys had, the great traditional metal sound, but you had what we would now these days call a lot of that extreme metal stuff. You guys were like Lamb of God before Lamb of God existed, A lot of that heavy brutality to the sound. And a lot of people who don't know that much about Vicious Rumors don't even realize that you guys went way back before that. I mean, to the Shrapnel days when Mike Varney signed you guys. Vinnie Moore was in the band for a while, But
that's correct. Yeah, we have a very long history that Well, I'll tell you, one of the great things about it now, especially, is that every year I get approached by a promoter or a festival or an interested party to do some kind of something special from my past. And when you're plugging away every year and you're trying to make out a new record and you're thinking of a new album, and like my mind is always thinking going forward, not really going backward.
Right.
But I'll tell you what, when we got the opportunity, the promoter of the Headbangers Open Air Festival in Germany invited us to play, and he really wanted us to do a Soldiers of the Night reunion. And I just didn't think it was going to happen. I had lost touch with Gary St. Pierre. I knew Vinny was in the UFO, and I just didn't think it was possible. But Vinny was unavailable for it, but just out of the blue, Gary had gotten in touch with me, and the next thing this whole thing was set up, and Gary came over as a special guest, and we did like half the Soldiers of the Night album. And and then later the next year we did a Digital Dictator reunion with Carl Albert's son and Mark McGee and Tommy Sisko on bass. So like, we've just had this long history, man, and it's just incredible that now we can celebrate it in all these different sort of reunions. And my current lineup, you know, they're just, they understand the longevity of the band and the history of the group. And I think they, you know, they get a kick out of it too, just being part of this huge family. We, even at the Alcatraz Festival last summer, we did the largest reunion at one time. We had 9 former members of Vicious Rumors on stage at once, spanning about 18 years of the band. It was incredible. It was myself, Steve Smyth, Ira Black, Kiyoshi Morgan on guitar. We had Larry Howe, Will Carroll on drums, both 2 drum sets set up, Stephen Goodwin on bass, Brian Allen, and James Rivera on vocals. And what we did was we invited, it was funny because I'm in the catering room backstage and I'm looking around, I just started noticing, oh my God, there's Ira, there's James, there's, you know, I'm looking around at all these, the members of these bands, I'm going, man, there's 20 years worth of Vicious Rumors right there. So it just hit me right there in the catering room. I'm like, man, I'm going to invite everybody to play a song. So I, you know, I just invited everyone to come up and do Don't Wait for Me at the end of our set. And it was incredible, man. You know, the people in the front of the band, and just even people that didn't know the group, but the people that really did know the group, their eyes were just huge, man, just looking at the 9 of us play this song. And it was really cool, man. And to make this long story, wrap up this long story, it's been really fun to be able to celebrate, you know, the history of the band and do a lot of different things like that. But overall, man, we're just moving forward, like, on this new album, Electric Punishment.
Exactly, and I want to talk about that in just a moment. And you do, you have a stellar lineup now, you know, Thane Rasmussen, who is in Heathens, been in the band for, like, off and on a little bit, but for basically 6 years now, 6-7 years. Larry's been with you basically since the beginning, other than a short hiatus. You know, Steven's been right with you for 6-7 years, and Brian's the new kid, and he's been in the band for what, 4 years now, something like that?
Just a little over 3 years. You're right, man. So it's like, yeah, it's been a great run, and I got a great group of guys, and so we're going full speed ahead.
Let's talk about the new stuff, because Electric Punishment is getting ready to drop. And it's a phenomenal album. And I was actually surprised you guys were ready so quickly for a new album. I mean, you took 5 years, you know, between Sadistic and Warball, another 5 between Warball and Razorback Killers. And then, bam, you barely got time to wipe your nose and change your sheets, and you've got another album ready.
Man, I'll tell you what, it's been incredible. The last 3 years, we've had an album every year. 2011, Razorback Killers. 2012, Live You to Death.
Right.
2013, Electric Punishment. And you know, I'll tell you, those 5 years in between Sadistic Symphony and Warball and Razorback Killers, certainly something we never planned. And that's really, it's amazing that Vicious Rumors was able to survive that kind of a drought. And really, it's just life. You know, when you have a band together for 33 plus years, man, life gets in the way sometimes. And it's just some unavoidable stuff that just was killing the momentum of the band. You know, changing labels, changing members, you know, personal family issues, you know, you name it, trying to just keep 5 guys together. You know, in this day and age, you know, just keeping 2 people together is hard enough, you know. But we certainly never intended on long gaps like that. And that's what will kill a band every time. Miraculously, we survived through it. And now we're on a pace. We have a goal to do 6 albums in 6 years, and we're halfway there. And the momentum that we've seen right now from doing these 3 albums in 3 years is just remarkable. We've had the best touring years of the band's career. We've played more festivals around the world than ever, and better slots on the bill. We're seeing our attendance get better at the shows. I mean, it's really starting to happen, and it's just the momentum. I mean, I say starting to happen, but, you know, we've just had a long career that's gone up and down. And right now we're on a very positive upswing, man, and things. It's a good time for Vicious Rumors. We're putting out a lot of good music, and people seem to be responding to it really well. So it's been a great, exciting time, my friend, and we're just going to try to keep it going. You know, we were on tour. Aside from making those records, we were on tour almost 8 months. So what we did is we just went straight into pre-production after the 70 Tons of Metal cruise in 2012. And spent, while we were putting the live album together, we just wrote music. We didn't really do gigs except for a short two-week festival run in Europe. And it was pre-production all year. It was 5 years to make the last one, 8 months to make this one. And, sometimes pressure's good. And, we had a lot of inspiration from an amazing 2011. And, we started the recording November 10th, and we finished January 14th.
Well, you get out on the road like that, and you do those big shows. It gets the adrenaline pump, and the energy comes back, and everything. And you've got some great guests on this album. You know, Brad Gelss is there. You also had your pal come in and do a little of the guitar work for you to give yourself a bit of a rest. But when I first threw the album on, as soon as I heard "I Am the Gun" and "Black X List," it took me all the way back to like the late '80s, early '90s with the Vicious Rumors album, "Digital Dictator," "Welcome to the Ball," had that really early classic Vicious Rumors feel. But in listening to the entire album, it really feels like you've sort of encompassed a little bit of every generation or era, if you will, of the band's sound. Am I like way off base?
I don't think so at all. I don't think you are at all, man. You know, like I had mentioned earlier, we're influenced by, we have a lot of different kind of aspects to our influences and to our sounds. You know, like, I think we're kind of just one of the few metal bands that can sort of do a ballad like Escape from Hell and then do like the fastest speed track we've ever done with D-Block and still have it sort of make sense on the same record. We just sort of have a knack of like kind of mixing these styles together to create Vicious Rumors. And, I just like to think that after all these years, it's just all the experience that all the guys have been through and, and us just trying to do what we do, just keep doing what we do and stay true to it, and not try to be somebody we're not, we just try to play music that we enjoy. And, for myself personally, when we put together these records, it's just very important for me to just kind of create a ride, that you start with on the first song and you end with on the last song. And that's what I try to do with every record. I just try to give it a place that it takes you. And, it's been a good response so far. And you know Vicious Rumors from way back when, and so it's just been an amazing run. But we really like to incorporate all the different elements, but this album in particular is probably the most versatile album that we've done since Word of Mouth in 94 way I would say it, because so many different kind of things on it. But
right. Well, and it's funny you said to the last song and all that stuff. And the last song on the album, you did a cover of Kiss's Strange Ways, which goes all the way back to their 1974 Hotter Than Hell album, sort of an obscure track to pick, but a phenomenal rendition. How did you pick that of all things to cover?
Well, it's funny. I always loved that song. I've been a huge Kiss fan forever, and I always loved that song. I just thought, man, I just remember, when I got Hotter Than Hell, I just thought, oh, man, I hope Kiss just goes this direction, I just wanted him to keep getting heavy like that, I just thought it was the heaviest Kiss song, and I just loved it, just how it was just so slow and heavy. And we kind of did it a little VR version. We kind of, sped it up just a little bit and, did our VR thing to it. But I've always loved that song, man, as a kid, and really wanted to cover it in the past, but it's just never really fit. Like, I can't imagine Strange Ways on Digital Dictator. You know what I mean?
Right.
It just didn't fit on any record until now. And it just became really apparent after the songwriting process of just sort of putting together riffs and the songs we felt were the strongest, once we realized that we were going to be doing, this is really shaping up to be a pretty versatile album, then it really just hit me like, wow, this is the album to put Strange Ways on. And then actually, once we got the whole sequence together, I thought it just made a lot of sense to me, and the guys liked it, and you know, we hope that the fans like it too. It's just, it's a fun song, and it's kind of nasty, a little nasty vibe, and it was fun to do all the vocals. I did all the vocals and guitars on that one. It was fun, and my voice kind of Gene and Peter anyway a little bit, so it was kind of a good song for me to do.
Well, it's funny. I don't know how big of a Kiss fan you were. You know, ironically, literally, just like a couple of weeks ago, I talked to Richie Weiss, who produced that album. He was in that proto-metal band, I don't know if you remember, Dust from New York, and he and Kenny Kerner ended up producing the first two Kiss albums. And we were talking about those albums, and both he and Kenny both said the first album was phenomenal, but the second album was really bizarre. They didn't think the songs were as strong, and it was just a really weird atmosphere. And I got the vibe on that album of the really weird atmosphere, but I thought the songs were incredible. There was some great stuff there. And Strange Ways, if you really listen to it, long before we had groove metal, here was a song that really had a lot of groove in it.
Oh, yeah, yeah. That was just such a sludgy kind of, like, you know, especially the way they played it. They did it really slow, you know? And, yeah, I know what you mean, man. It had that, like, slow kind of hypnotic groove. And but, yeah, the production on the Hotter Than Hell album, I thought, you know, kind of suffered a little bit. But in a way it was so strange that it kind of just had a cool sound. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
Yeah.
Now, and while we're talking about some of the old stuff like that, that was one of the questions I wanted to ask you, because for whatever reason, I never got to be the one that interviewed you way back in the day when we interviewed you probably half a dozen times for The Informant. Was there like sort of an epiphany moment for you, a seminal moment when you were growing up, whether it was a song, an album, or a concert or something, where you just went, that's what I want to do with my life?
Absolutely, man. You know, it's hard for me to say a pivotal moment, but I will say this. When I was a young man growing up in Hawaii, a young boy, my sister was like 18 years old, and her friends used to come home from school, and they, you know, put on Led Zeppelin records and, you know, some Black Sabbath and stuff like that. And I would kind of just see their reaction to the music and just listen to like how loud it was coming out of her room. And I just always remember just thinking like how great that was. And I remember my sister took me to see Wishbone Ash at the Andrews Amphitheater in the university campus of Hawaii in Honolulu. And it was in the 70s. And, you know, that was like, I think the first time I'd ever seen a flying V, you know, and I just was like, oh, that's it, you know? So maybe that might have been the hook, line, and sinker, but I'm gonna give most of the credit to my older sister and her friends, and just for letting me hang out with them and just sort of get the feel of the power of music and then what it does to groups of people.
When you first started writing music and creating the band, was there a certain group that you were set of groups that you were trying to emulate? Because you guys were a lot heavier than anything that we had really had going at the time. You know, and obviously you were into Kiss, but what were some of the other bands that were really inspirational to you?
Yeah, for me, as growing up in Hawaii, I was just, you know, searching music, you know, searching it out. And the bands that really, you know, in the beginning, it was like Zeppelin and, you know, stuff like that. 10 years after, you know, of course, Jimi Hendrix, I was always blown away by, still am. And then it started getting darker and got into Judas Priest and Black Sabbath. And then once that started happening, that sort of like the floodgates opened to me when I really found out, you know, those bands. The Priest and Sabbath like were really crucial for me. Like, I just, you know, I really identified with those two groups. And also, you know, Maiden a little bit later.
Right. Electric Punishment comes out at the end of April over in Europe, here in the States on May 7th. Are you guys going to be doing any videos for this one? I know it's hard to do these days, expense-wise.
You know, actually, we just shot a really cool video for the song I Am the Gun. And it's the first song on the record, and that's going to probably be out on all over Facebook, our website, all over YouTube. I would say within the week.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, and it was a really cool kind of dark video about different people's relations to their guns, and basically like the primal instinct that man has to kill each other. And, you know, it's a cool, wicked song called "I Am the Gun," and yeah, that's going to be the first sort of single and video off the record. We also, you know, we've got 60 shows on the schedule right now that. We've got a monster year planned for this year. We start in Europe on May 3rd, and we're doing like 26 shows all over May, all over Europe in the month of May. And then we come, we'll be home for about 6 weeks, and doing probably a few maybe local runoffs, and then back to Europe for summer festivals,
right?
Like Headbangers Open Air, Alcatraz Festival again. The Stonehenge Festival in the Netherlands, and a few other ones, July 26th through August 11th. And then I'm really happy to share with you and your audience that Vicious Rumors will be doing a full U.S. tour. We're going to be headlining the Metal Masters Tour featuring Vicious Rumors, Leather Wolf, and Seven Witches.
Oh, wow.
And that's going to be like 30 dates all over the United States and Canada.
Excellent.
And that's coming up in around September 18th to around October 20th, possibly longer.
So we'll look forward to those dates coming out in the not too distant future.
Yeah, it's going to be a big year for VR and for for the bringing the Electric Punishment to the United States again. Really looking forward to that, cuz we've been working nonstop. It's just been overseas. So we're really happy to see that, you know, spill back over into the U.S. And, you know, it's been a while since we did a full tour like that. So, yeah, it's an exciting time, man. I just want to thank you for, all the support over the years. And really appreciate it, man.
Absolutely. So Record Store Day is coming up here in about another week. And, of course, that reminds me of the days hanging out at Rasputin's and whatnot, looking at all the old vinyl records. I'm sure you did exactly the same thing. Are you guys going to be releasing a version of this on vinyl?
Absolutely. We've got a really cool limited edition double album with a couple of bonus tracks from the live album on the vinyl also. There's 12 songs on it, the 10 from the record and two live tracks split into two beautiful slabs of green marble vinyl.
Nice.
So it's like a very cool package. And yeah, that's a limited edition. I think there's only... maybe a few thousand copies of those, and that they come out the same day as the CD. So yeah, we do have a little limited edition vinyl run of that, and look for a lot more stuff coming from Vicious Rumors for sure, man. We're also planning on doing a Live You to Death 2, which will have a completely different live set. We've got a new studio album in the works. That we're already, conceptualizing and writing for and getting that whole thing ready. We even have plans for a Live You to Death 3, which would be a 2-CD, like 20 songs live. And all three of these Live You to Death albums will be completely different set lists.
Wow, so you can all, by the time it's all said and done, we'll have every track possible live.
Well, the funny thing is we've got so many records out, no. You won't, but you'll have about 40%. But hey, man, this is our 11th studio album.
That's
with
true.
Electric Punishment.
That's
so that's like 110 published songs or something. But hey, we're looking to put out 40 of them live on these cool Live You to Death collectible live albums. And it's also a great way to give us a little time to spend in working on each studio album. Man, we want to really give you our best effort every time. And that's one thing I'm really proud of working with these guys. You know, it's like every time we go in to do this, there isn't any song on any Vicious Rumors album that we put on as a filler, not one. And I'm really proud to say that.
Well, Jeff, I appreciate what you've been doing all these years. I've always loved the music way back from the club days and everything, and it's just so exciting to see you guys still putting out great albums. So we really want to get a new generation of VR fans out there as well. So, and hopefully, I doubt it, but hopefully you'll get to my burg one of these days on the tour, and I'll get a chance to catch you live again.
There's no doubt about it. So, hey, buddy, thanks so much, and it was a pleasure talking with you today, and thanks for everything and the support for the band, man.
Absolutely. Jeff Thorpe of Vicious Rumors. On our way out, we're going to play something from the new album, Electric Punishment. This is their cover of Kiss's Strange Ways. Crank it up.